another session of General Mathematics. This is your teacher, John Glenn Esalmario. Today we will be discussing Introduction to Logarithms. For your lesson objectives, after going through this lesson, you are expected to represent real-life situations using logarithmic functions and express logarithmic equations to exponential functions or exponential equations and vice versa. Let us start today's session with a prayer. Now everyone, let's bow down our heads and feel the presence of our Lord. Almighty Father, we thank you for the blessings that you continue to give us. May you guide us throughout the entire session so that the lessons that will be discussed to us will help us improve oneself and therefore take us one step closer to achieving our dreams. This we pray in the name of the Lord Jesus. Amen.
Vice versa.
For your motivation, let us solve for the value of the variables in the equations below. So here is an example. 4 raised to x is equal to 16. In order for us to solve for the value of x, we need to have 16 rewritten with base 4. 4 raised to a certain number. And what certain number is that we need to raise 4 to get 16? That's correct. We need 2. 16 can be rewritten as 4 raised to 2. And with this one, in this form, we can now solve for the value of x, which is equal to 2. Next, 4 raised to x is equal to 64. We need to rewrite 64 in terms of 4 raised to a certain number, which is 4 raised to 3. Therefore, for this instance, we can now solve for the value of x, which is 3. How about 4 raised to x is equal to 30? This might be a little bit challenging. Why? Because we do not know the certain number or the exact number for which we would have to raise 4 to get 30. We know for certain that the value of x is somewhere between 2 and 3. But how do we solve this? We need to use logarithms. Logarithms, introduced by John Napier in 1614 as a method to simplify calculations. Adopted by navigators, scientists, engineers, surveyors to others to perform high accuracy computations more easily with the use of logarithm tables and slide rule. The present day notion of logarithms comes from Leonhard Euler, who connected them to the exponential function in the 18th century, and who also introduced the letter E as the base of natural logarithms. Logarithms are also used in measuring signal level, music pitch, data storage, and strength of earthquakes. So, paano ba related ang exponential at logarithms? Ganito po, meron tayong exponential form, b raised to c is equals to a, and in logarithmic form, logarithm of a base b is equals to c. Take note of the variables kung saan sila nakalagay. Baka mapagpalit, okay? So, let us see. In both logarithmic and inequality forms, b is the base. So, in exponential form, sorry, this is exponent. In exponential form and in logarithmic form, b will always be the base. In exponential form, c is an exponent. So, dito, yung result ng logarithm ng certain base ay c, which is also becomes the exponent in exponential form. Next, in logarithmic form, a cannot be negative. I repeat, a cannot be negative. Bakit? Kasi kung matatandaan nyo sa exponential functions, ang result or ang range ng ating exponential function ay from 0, not including 0, to positive infinity. It will always be a positive number. At ito yung result na yun. Kaya hindi pwedeng maging negative yung ating result. Next, the result of the logarithmic form c can be negative. Kung yung A hindi pwedeng maging negative, etong C pwedeng maging negative. Bakit? Kasi kung i-apply natin ito into in exponential form, pwede tayong maglagay ng negative na exponent. Ang magiging sagot lang nun ay yung reciprocal ng base. Natandaan ba? Okay, good. Ngayon, paano ba tayo mag-convert ng exponential to logarithmic form? Ito yung ating exponential form kanina. B raised to C is equals to A. At yung logarithmic form, logarithm of A base B is equals to C. So, example, 2 raised to 3 is equals to 8. So, paano natin siya i-convert to logarithm form? Take note, ano ba tatandaan natin? Kailangan, pag kinonvert natin ito, kung makapasin nyo, ito yung kanyang form. Logarithm of 8 base 2 is equals to 3. Ganito po ang pagbabasa ha. Logarithm of 8 base 2 is equals to 3. Kuha ba? Okay, try natin iba. 9 raised to 3 is equals to 729. Pag kinonvert natin yan into logarithmic form, it would be logarithm of 729 base 9 is equals to 3. Kuha? Okay, good. Ito naman, 7 raised to 0 is equals to 1. In logarithmic form, this would be equal to, very good, logarithm of 1 base 7 is equals to 0. Next, logarithms and exponents allow us to express the same relationship in two different ways. How about itong naiwan natin kanina, 4 raised to x is equals to 30. So, paano natin masasolve yung value ng x? So, pwede natin siyang i-convert into logarithmic form. It would give us what? Logarithm of 30 base 4 is equals to x. At pag sinolve natin yan sa calculator, ang x natin ay equal to 2.4534. So, tama tayo. It is somewhere around between 2 and 3. Kuha? Okay, good. Now, here are some more examples. Let us rewrite the following exponential equations in logarithmic form. So, example, 5 raised to 3 is equals to 125. So, paano natin siya isusulat in logarithmic form? Again, anong dapat nating unang tandaan? Etong 125 na to ay iyan yung una nating mabasahin. Logarithm of 125. Then, ano susunod? Base? Anong base natin? Yung 5. So, logarithm of 125 base 5. Saan siya equal? Doon sa natin tira, which is the C or the exponent, which is 3. Ayan ha, mas padali. Next, 7 raised to negative 2 is equals to 1 over 49. So, paano natin siya co-convert to logarithmic form? Good. Logarithm of 1 over 49 base 7 is equals to negative 2. Is that valid? Yes, pwede tayo magkaroon ng negative na exponent at negative na result sa logarithm. Next, 10 raised to 2 is equals to 100. In logarithmic form, this is logarithm of 100 base 10 is equals to 2. Next, negative 2 raised to 2 is equals to 4. This would be logarithm of 4 base negative 2 is equals to 2. Tama kaya? Parang mali. Hindi parang. Mali talaga. Bakit kaya? This equation cannot be written or rewritten in logarithmic form. So, bakit kaya? Take note. Exponential functions are functions in the form of f of x equals to b raised to x, where b should be greater than 0 and not equal to 1. Kaso, ang base natin ay negative. So, hindi siya isang exponential function. Only exponential equations or functions that have base greater than 0 and base not equal to 1 can be expressed in logarithm form. Although, pag kinumpit natin siya, it could be correct. However, hindi siya valid as exponential equation. Kuha ba? Okay, good. Next, here are some types of logarithms. Let's start with common logarithms. Common logarithms are logarithms with base 10. The base 10 is usually omitted when writing. So this is designated as logarithm of x. Kapag wala kayong nakitang base, automatic common logarithm yun or base 10 kagad siya. Example, express logarithm of x is equals to 8 in exponential form. Again, kapag wala kayong nakitang base, automatic base 10 siya. So, pwede na siyang i-write as logarithm of 10 or logarithm of x base 10. I-substitute lang natin. Then, all we have to do is to rewrite this in exponential form. Anong exponential form nito? Very good. 10 raised to 8 is equals to x. Yan na ba sagot? Yan na sagot. Okay? Good. Next. Next type would be the natural logarithms. Natural logarithms are logarithms with base e. E is the Euler's number, which is 2.71828. And it is rewritten as ln of x. Ito yun. This is, we read this as ln, or the natural logarithm. Ln of x equals to, equal lang yun sa logarithm of x base e. Kung kanina, ang common base 10, ito base e, which is the Euler's number. Example, express ln of 6 is equals to x in exponential form. So again, isa-substitute lang natin yung ln of 6 as logarithm of 6 base e. Sub natin sa equation. Then, write this in exponential form, which is e raised to x is equals to 6. Yan na ba sagot? Yan ang sagot. Kuha ba? Okay, good. Now, let us rewrite the following logarithmic equations in exponential form. So, baliktad naman. Example, we have logarithm of 81 base 3 is equals to 4. So, paano natin siya i-rewrite in exponential form? So, etong tips ko sa inyo. Etong dalawa, yan yung pagko-combining, yan yung magkasama. Tanda natin, b is the base. So, meaning to say, etong 4 or c, yan ang ating exponent. 3 raised to 4. Saan siya equal? Equal siya sa matitirang number, which is the a, 81. Yan na lang natin. Yan na lang siya equal. Kuha ba? Good. Next, logarithm of x base 5 is equals to 7. In exponential form, that is 5 raised to 7 is equals to x. Next, ln of 4 is equals to x. That is a natural logarithm, base e. Kung ang base natin ay e, this would mean, in exponential form, it is e raised to x equals to 4. Kapag ln, sure ball e yan. Okay? Next, logarithm of 5, base square root of 5, is equals to 2. Sir, valid ba yun? Yes. Square root of 5 is greater than 0. Okay? And it is also what? A positive number. So, paano natin siya i-rewrite in exponential form? This is what? Square root of 5 squared is equals to 5. Kuha? Good. How about logarithm of 9 base a? Sir, walang base. Kapag walang base, it means it is a common logarithm. At ang base ng common logarithm ay 10. So, kapag rewrite natin to in exponential form, this is equal to or equivalent to 10 raised to a is equals to 9. Kuha ba? Okay, good. Ngayon, how do we use logarithms in real-life situations? In acoustics, the decibel or dB level of sound is d is equals to 10 logarithm of quantity I over 10 raised to negative 12. For example, the decibel level in a quiet office is 10 raised to negative 6 watts per meter squared. What is the corresponding sound intensity in decibel? So, paano natin malalaman yung sound intensity? So substitute lang natin yung 10 raised to negative 6 dun sa letter I, which is yun yung given. So all we have to do now is to solve. At ang resulting nito ay 10 times logarithm 10 raised to 6. Paano nangyari yun? Kasi by laws of exponent, ito, kapag meron tayong same base is divided, i-minus lang natin, this is the quotient rule. Isusubtract lang natin. Okay? Susubtract lang natin to. 6 minus negative 12 is positive 6. Kapag kinumpit natin yan, this would be what? 60 decibels. Kuha? Okay, good. Now, let's have a recap ng mga napag-aralan natin ngayon. Logarithm is the inverse of exponentiation. Good. Next, logarithms can be expressed in exponential form and vice versa. So, from logarithm, pwede siyang convert sa exponential, then exponential, pabalik sa logarithm. Ito yung kanyang logarithmic form. Logarithm of a base b is equals to c, papunta sa exponential form, which is b raised to c is equals to a. Then, pabalik sa logarithmic form. Okay? Good. Next, common logarithms are logarithms with base 10 and can be expressed as logarithm of x. So, is equals to logarithm of x base 10. So, kahit wala siyang base, ibig sabihin, common logarithm siya. Natural logarithms are logarithms with base e and can be expressed as ln of x. Is equals to, kapag nakakita ninyo ng ganyan, ln of any number, matic, base e siya, logarithm. Kuha ba? Okay, good. And now, for your favorite part.
Get ready for the next battle.
Okay. So for this one, let's try to practice what we have just learned. We write the following logarithmic equations in exponential form. So itong apat na to. Ayan. I-rewrite lang natin yung logarithmic to exponential form. Kahit mental, kayang-kaya nga yan. Then, ito naman, rewrite the following exponential equations in logarithmic form. Pabalik. Apat naman to. Okay, guys. Pause mo na yung video. After yan, check natin kung tama yung sagot nyo. Okay? I trust you guys. Good luck.
A few moments later.
Okay. So, check natin kung tama yung sagot nyo. So, for this one, rewrite the following logarithmic equations in exponential form. Check natin kung tama. Logarithm of 243 base 3 is equals to 5 in exponential form, that is 3 raised to 5 is equals to 243. Very good. Letter B, logarithm of 64 over 27 base 3 over 4 is equals to negative 3. This is what? 3 over 4 raised to negative 3 is equals to 64 over 27. Next, logarithm of m is equals to n. This is what? A common logarithm. So, ang base nga ay 10. So, in exponential form, that would be 10 raised to n is equals to m. Next, ln of 8 is equals to a. Letter D is an example of a natural logarithm with base e. So, this is, in exponential form, this is written as e raised to a is equals to 8. Very good. Now, dito naman sa baba. I-rewrite daw natin in logarithmic form. So, dito, ano kaya sagot? That would be logarithm of 4 over 121 base 11 over 2 is equals to negative 2. Very good. How about this one? Logarithm of, very good, 0.001 is equals to negative 3. Bakit nawala yung 10? Kasi, tama rin naman, logarithm of 0.001 base 10. Kaso, mas appropriate na tanggalin na natin. Bakit? Kasi, base 10 naman siya. This could be, or this is a common logarithm. Next, e raised to 2 is equals to x. So, this can be rewritten as Logarithm of E? Logarithm of what? Logarithm of X base E is equals to 2, or ln of X, because this is an example of a natural logarithm. And for the fourth one, logarithm of, very good, logarithm of 21 base 7 is equals to B. Nakuha ba lahat ng sagot? Okay, very good.
And that concludes our session. Thank you very much for watching my video. I hope you learned something new today. Please subscribe to my channel and click the bell button for notifications. Should you have any questions or clarifications, you can send me a message through Messenger or an email through my Gmail account. And again, this is Sir Glenn saying, remember, trust the process. Bye guys, see you soon. If you live for something, you're